A lot of what's published on the internet about WordPress hosting is total and complete nonsense. In most cases, it's even flat out lies. There are plenty of companies who just change the name of their regular web hosting packages to WordPress Optimized, then pay people to promote it, and this way they trick users into thinking they're buying actually good WordPress hosting plans. And this makes me mad because here's the thing, WordPress software runs fine on typical web hosting plans, so they can get away with selling you regular plans just renamed WordPress Hosting. But WordPress does have some needs and requirements that are not generic, so some companies can offer seriously better performance and support. But these companies get lost in the sea of BS recommendations. So in this video, I want to show you what to look for when choosing the best WordPress hosting provider. Which optimizations matter, which ones don't. I'll also include some performance tests from various web hosting companies and give you some unbiased data-based recommendations. Let's start by looking at what you should pay attention to when choosing your WordPress hosting. The configuration is much more important than the raw specs of your plan. Let me explain. Let's say you find a web hosting provider that's offering you 50GB storage, 100GB bandwidth, 20 domains, 20 databases, 20 FTP accounts, full DNS management, and $0 setup with instant activation and has the tag WordPress Optimized. Seems like a lot, yeah? But does that actually mean anything? No. No, it does not. It's exactly the same as the car salesman that's going to sell you a car that has these features. 4 wheels, 1 steering wheel, full coat of paint, ability to turn off and on lights whenever you want, a full engine, and fuel management, while having the tag Road Optimized. Sounds silly when we put it that way, yeah? So the question is, what does matter and what do you need to look out for when you're choosing the best WordPress hosting provider? Litespeed, Apache, or NGINX technology, some sort of a database caching solution, support for PHP 7, and HTTP 2, preferably both. These are the keywords you should pay attention to. This is the core of a fast WordPress website, and everything else is simply a nice bonus. I've monitored and I continue to monitor plenty of web hosting companies, so what I did is I ranked them based on the performance and price ratio that they offer for their web hosting plans for WordPress. I'm only gonna talk about the companies that I actually recommend. I'm not gonna waste your time talking about something that's bad just to pad out the time of this video. And you'll really want to watch this video because the difference of exactly the same priced WordPress plans with different providers that use different configurations can be as much as 2 times. Hostinger is one of the cheapest providers you can find on the market right now. Their plans for WordPress optimized web hosting start from $2.15 per month, but you can get that down to $1.94 per month using the links below and typing in coupon code. Oh, by the way, I want to mention that if you make any purchases using the links down below, I'll actually make a commission and you'll get a discount. This is simply the best way for me to keep my content sponsored and ad-free and make some money at the same time. So, thank you for your support, and if you decide to use the links down below, enjoy your discounts. Hostinger ticks 2 of the 3 boxes that we discussed previously. They have configured their servers to use Litespeed, they're running PHP 7.4, which is the latest version as of making this video, and they take advantage of the NGINX technology. The only thing their servers are missing is a dedicated caching solution like Memcached. Once inside your Hostinger account, you'll be able to install WordPress on any of your plans automatically with just a couple of clicks. Just click Manage next to your hosting plan, then choose Auto Installers. From the menu, choose WordPress and fill out all of the required information. I've created this website and tested out the loading speed using GT metrics. My fully designed webpage with Hostinger WordPress hosting loaded in 2 seconds. This is using PHP 7.4, Litespeed cache, and image optimizations that were automatically activated when I installed WordPress with Hostinger. Litespeed cache actually comes pre-installed with your WordPress installation, but you can actually download the plugin yourself if you want to from the WordPress plugin store as well. But keep in mind that Litespeed cache only works with web hosting providers that use Litespeed servers. For reference, I imported the same exact design into my WordPress website created with HostGator. They also advertise WordPress hosting and the increase in speed, but they don't use the technologies mentioned earlier, and they only run on PHP 7.1 at best. The exact same website loaded in 4.8 seconds. Just to prove my point that configuration matters more than raw specs when it comes to WordPress, and not every single WordPress hosting comes created equally, what I did is I optimized all of the images on my HostGator website and reduced the website size by like 40%. Then I redid the test and it was still twice as slow, loading in 4.1 seconds. I've also tested how stable Hostinger is using Pingdom. In the last 30 days, my website with Hostinger was offline for 7 minutes in total, scoring Hostinger a 99.98% uptime. So on average, you'll have no problems with your website being offline when you need it. I also really like that Hostinger comes with 24/7 easy-to-access support. Just click this icon right here and start chatting. When it comes to response times, I can't really give like an honest review on them because your mileage will vary. You might get an answer within 1 minute or 1 hour, depending on how heavy loaded the support staff is at the moment. But it's always nice to know that you can contact them for free and they'll do their best to help you out whichever way they can, whenever they can. One of the best features for me is that you're able to send and receive pictures through their chat. Most other companies offer text only, and this makes it easier to explain your problem or follow instructions. So if you're looking for a fast website that's not gonna cost you a ton of money, I recommend you go with the Hostinger WordPress plans because they're gonna cost you like $2 a month and you're gonna get top-notch performance. However, if you got some money to spend, keep watching, I got better options coming up, but they're gonna be more expensive. SiteGround is another company that has true WordPress optimized plans. They're using NGINX and Apache, have the latest PHP version, which is currently 7.4, and have developed a custom caching solution based on Memcached. They tick all of the three boxes for good WordPress optimized infrastructure. They actually take it one step further by offering users SG Optimizer, a custom plugin that only works on SiteGround and allows you to further optimize your website yourself. And most importantly, fast and easy. All you need to do to create a WordPress website with SiteGround is log in, click New Website, and follow their setup steps. Everything is done automatically and you'll have your website up and running in like 2 to 5 minutes. I've added the same exact WordPress design as to my Hostinger website, then I used SG Optimizer plugin that came with my plan and did everything it suggested to optimize my website. The process took another couple of minutes. In the end, Google rated my website a 95 out of 100. Then I've used GT Metrics to perform a speed test. As you can see, these optimizations weren't just for show. My website loaded in 2.1 seconds. I've also used Pingdom and monitored how stable SiteGround is for 30 days. My website experiences outages for 4 minutes in total, scoring SiteGround close to 100% uptime. On average, I would say that SiteGround is faster than Hostinger. Their control panel is also easier and faster to navigate, and you get more optimization options. However, this comes at a cost. SiteGround is not a cheap product. Usually, SiteGround plans are somewhere between $4 to $6. However, currently, they have a special promotion going on where you can get 3 months for just 99 cents. Depending on when you watch this video, this deal might not be available anymore. However, I will update the description with the most recent deals or coupons, so you always get the best deal. So here's what I mean when I say SiteGround is not cheap. The cheapest 3-year SiteGround plan will cost you $230. For reference, the cheapest Hostinger plan was $43, and it was for 4 years, not 3. However, SiteGround does include some features that Hostinger doesn't have. That's website staging and automatic updates. SiteGround automatically updates your WordPress to the latest version. This also includes plugins. You can toggle this function on and off. It's a nice time saver in my books. So there's a considerable difference between SiteGround and Hostinger prices. Even though SiteGround on average is faster, it's also way more expensive. So who do I recommend SiteGround to? Well, if you got the budget, you don't really care about the money, you just want the fastest website available, then SiteGround might be right up your alley. So a non-problem problem that SiteGround and Hostinger has is that they don't use the standard cPanel control tools. Both of these hosting providers have developed their own control panels. Just for reference, here's the Hostinger panel, they call it the H-panel. This is the SiteGround custom solution that they've just released, and this is the cPanel that A2Hosting has. If we would dive into their server specs, however, they have Litespeed server technology. You can see that they utilized Memcached and used PHP 7 and above. So A2Hosting ticks all of the three boxes required for fast WordPress hosting. The bad part is that to get these optimized plans, you'll need to buy at least the Turbo Boost plan, which is $9.99 a month, and that's with a 50% discount. You can get the discount yourself as well by using the links below. Anything below the Turbo plan does not come with these necessary optimizations, so keep that in mind. For a 3-year plan, you're gonna end up spending $360. That's quite a hefty chunk. But you do get absolutely everything you need to start a successful website, like updates, backups, staging, support, and most importantly, cPanel controls if you're looking for that sort of stuff. To give you some performance results, the WordPress website I have installed with A2Hosting loads in 2.1 seconds, which is on par with Hostinger and SiteGround. In terms of stability, A2Hosting performs excellent as well. In the last 30 days, my A2Hosting website was only offline for 8 minutes, scoring at an uptime of 99.98%. And most importantly, A2Hosting WordPress plans come with A2 Optimizer plugin as well, already installed in your WordPress client. This plugin will allow you managing your WordPress optimizations from one place, and it will give you some tips and easy access to perform optimizations yourself. The question is, should you choose A2Hosting to host your WordPress website? Well, I can only recommend them if you want cPanel controls, because in my opinion, Hostinger is a better cheaper option, SiteGround is a better premium option. However, if you're currently with A2Hosting, you're in good hands. I don't recommend you go out and switch, especially if you never had problems with them. They're working just fine, I just think that their prices are a little bit too steep at the moment. When we're talking about WordPress, there's no way around it, so we have to talk about the elephant in the room, which is Bluehost. Absolutely any article you'll read online about WordPress hosting will have Bluehost rated as the number one provider. Even WordPress themselves put Bluehost as the number one recommended host, and even I made a video like a year back recommending them for WordPress.
WordPress has been recommending Bluehost since 2005. And with good reason.
What changed? Nothing. Absolutely nothing changed. And that's the problem. Time went on and Bluehost didn't upgrade their tech at all. Here I've set up the exact same test scenario as I had for other hosts on this list using Bluehost, and it loaded my website in 4.2 seconds. Very similar to HostGator, and that's no surprise. Both HostGator and Bluehost are owned by the same company, and they're using very similar tech. When it comes to stability, Bluehost also performed the worst out of all companies on this list, scoring just 99.96% with a total of 16 minutes of downtime. Bluehost actually ticks 0 out of the 3 speed checkboxes we determined were important to have a fast WordPress website, and their stats perfectly reflect this. They're slow compared to others on this list. Does this mean that Bluehost is bad for WordPress? The number one recommended provider by WordPress themselves is not all that great? This might sound confusing, but actually, no. And before you call me a sellout in the comments down below, hear me out, I actually have valid points for this. For some reason, Bluehost actually decided to compete in a completely different way. While every single web hosting provider is rushing to get the latest tech, the fastest servers, the best loading times, Bluehost is focusing on the most complete user experience. I would actually compare them to Apple. Everybody knows that the Apple tech isn't the fastest or the cheapest. There are faster and cheaper phones, tablets, computers available, but Apple is loved by millions across the world because of the user experience and all the features and the feel you get when you use their services.
Bluehost offers a lot of easy-to-access tools that are complicated otherwise. You can set up Google Ads,
ads straight from your Bluehost dashboard and advertise your website on Google to drive additional traffic. A really great tool for business owners that comes with the base Bluehost package. And if you're running an e-commerce store, ads are pretty much a must. They have this easy to follow steps program as well, where they show you what you need to do in order to make sure your website is the best it can be. You can tackle problems one by one and make sure you're not forgetting anything important. You can tick the box once the job is done and you'll get some advice from Bluehost. For an additional cost, they even help you out with SEO, helping you get your business discovered. They'll also send you monthly reports of how you're doing versus your competition and stuff like that. They'll also allow you to manage comments on your website directly through their dashboard, and Bluehost takes care of the updates automatically, even with the cheapest plan. If you use the links below, you can get a discount. With this, Bluehost plans start at $2.95 a month, so you can snag a 3-year plan for roughly $100. It's not terribly expensive as well, obviously not as cheap as Hostinger, but it's in the middle of SiteGround and A2Hosting. Don't get me wrong, absolutely everything that Bluehost is offering in terms of these extra features, you can do yourself with other web hosting providers. But do you want to? Think of this as building a computer yourself versus buying a pre-built one. For me personally, I don't find the Bluehost features all that appealing. I can do everything myself and I prefer to do everything myself. But at the same time, I can understand how most people value their features over server speed. Because even if you have the fastest server in the world, it's not gonna save your website if you have no idea what you're doing with it. Okay, let's sum this up. We talked about three web hosting providers that have meaningful WordPress optimizations in place and offer the fastest services. And then we talked about one that has just the best user experience in place. Which one should you get?
If you're looking for an affordable choice that has all of the necessary optimizations in place, offers 24/7 support and all of that good stuff, go with Hostinger. They're by far the cheapest and the service is top notch. If you don't care about the money, you just want to have the fastest website with the most user-friendly controls, go with SiteGround. They're a premium host that uses the newest technologies. You'll always have the latest toys to play with, but again, it comes at a price. A2Hosting, if you care about speed but don't want to use anything else besides cPanel. And finally, Bluehost, if you don't care about your speed, since they're twice as slow as everything else on this list, but you're new to website creation and you'll take advantage of their beginner-tailored features.
My name is Emit and feel free to start the discussion down in the comments. For this video, I've tried to be as unbiased as possible, covering multiple different angles and doing all sorts of performance tests. I do a lot of web hosting related stuff on my channel, and if you're like a new webmaster, you're definitely gonna find some valuable information there, so consider subscribing. And as always, good luck making your websites.